It's a sunny day here at Canadian Tire Motorsports Park, and Eric DeMax won the pole here at this track, and he's going to be leading us down for that green flag here, and there it is. Green flag is out in the air. Eric DeMax with the advantage into the first corner there, and he's going to take it away quite easily there, as Benyako's going to have to deal with a hard-charging John Arndt. Already you see these drivers getting aggressive on that first lap here. Track position is fundamental here at Canadian Tire. You need as much as you can if you want to get up to that front there, as Arndt's going to battle for a second underneath Yakko there. But Eric DeMax still with the advantage there, with a solid foundation for that race lead right there. But the CM Racing cars are still going at it here. Sean Angel, the home hero coming in here, the hometown hero to be exact, is running in that fourth spot. Richardson right on his inside there. Richardson trying to find some redemption here in terms of his road course success. And looks like the top four is going to pan out relatively well here as they go through the Andretti Straight. Eric DeMax continues to lead the field. Good run from Benyako on that straightaway there, and he's looking underneath John Arndt there in the right-hander. Both cars are still side-by-side, and this is just what Eric DeMax needs behind his mirror there. The two are still going at it fiercely for the second position there. Richardson there waiting to watch these two go at it. But Benyako, one of the more, younger road course ringers on the track there, certainly trying to show that his win was not a fluke, and he still has that road course expertise in them. Yakko still side by side with Arndt there. Arndt has the advantage right over there in the Moss. And looks like Yakko still has his nose right there. Wide apex for the 88. And so that 8 car is going to be able to take advantage of that. And Benyako and really John Arndt still going to be going at it for quite some time here. But fantastic battles here at Canadian Tire in the early stages of this race here. Those are certainly drivers to really look out for here in this event. While that battle was commencing, Sam Adamson got turned by TJ Martin when he dove into the corner a bit too hot, turning the 62 into the tire barrier. And that is really pretty much a tough break for Sam Adamson there. He's been on a downslope this season, and certainly this is not really going to help his confidence as well as his results yet again. James Richardson's putting a lot of pressure on hometown hero Sean Angel. He's got to run the outside line there. He goes into the grass there. And Richardson trying to get hard on the brakes. They're trying to outbrake that number 6 car there. But Richardson still has the edge there. Angel gets the run off the corner there with straightaway speed. And here they come down, hit the hill here. And in a Moss, Richardson's still on the brakes there. Angel really dove it in there really hard there. Dreadful inside there. Hannah Allen went off the track trying to get around Salmon, but Richardson still has his ground maintained there. He gets the inside line run off and forced John Angel to go a bit wide there. And James Richardson now up to P4 right now in the race. That is a great effort for this 17 car. They're certainly trying to find some lost ground here today. It's a 4-car train for the 7th position here. Jack Porkins getting shoved out of the line there by Alexander Rowe there. That 05 car has found some speed here today in Mossport. And he's going to have a look on the inside of that 95 car for the 8th position there. Rowe looking very strong here in this long run here, even though it's only lap 5 of the race. But even so, that 05 car showing some promise there. He just got around a CM Racing car. Remember, they are affiliates for the team, so, or startup team, they're doing a phenomenal job right now. A top 10, I think, would be a good victory for them in order to get stronger and stronger as that season progresses. Give a shout out to Alexander Rowe. Vince Freeze and Scott Roush would tangle up out of Moss into the straightaway, and both of them make contact with that concrete barrier there, and that is a lot of damage to that Geico machine there. And they're hopefully going to have that insurance pay that Ford Mustang, because Vince Freeze certainly not having the luck he's wanted all season ever since he stepped into that number 26. TJ Martin has been struggling throughout this race so far, as Aiden Shepherd's going to make a move underneath that 71. Huge run on the inside. Martin had to go a bit wide there. Emmett Juckum's going to try and take advantage as both of them make contact there. And Juckum barely kept his wheels off the grass there. That would have been disastrous for the 07 car. And Jonathan Wong had to back off as a result. A really close call for the points leader coming in here. Remember, he has a 1-point gap in front of Jake West, who's actually running ahead of that number 71 He was running around that 15th spot there. He's trying to get himself into that top 10, but both really the top two competitors are pretty much struggling on the track right now. Jake West is getting held up by Vince Freeze here. Here comes a massive wad of cars coming into the picture there. Cody Lamas, Aiden Shepherd, DeLeo, and TJ Martin, as well as Juckum there. And West is going to try and look underneath that 26 car. And looks like he's going to get through them in the S's here, but Freeze still holding his line there. West is going to be able to get away with it, but look at the amount of cars all stacked up behind that 26 car. Shepherd goes on by, as well as TJ Martin. But all those drivers pretty much giving each other some good old space here, and that could have been a lot of cars that could have wrecked out because of that stack up there, and Jake West able to get away with it, but that championship fight is still heating up between those two drivers. But don't count out those within that top three in points, as well as those actually further back, because they could be able to pounce on the situation based on how these two are running at the moment. Eric DeMax is getting held up by John Bunnell there in that 53 there. And DeMax is really trying to find a way to get around him. This is going to really help the CM Racing cars of Benyako and Arndt to kick into the picture here, as those two are going to be right behind that Chevrolet. It's a Chevy top three at the moment, but James Richardson, don't count him out just yet. He's going to be in the fray, as well as Sean Angel. You see that white car in the background there, as those three cars are now single file on a line here. Depends on which car will make their move first, but Eric DeMax still trying to hold on, and John Arndt actually is going to look for that second spot in the S's there. A bold maneuver there from the 88 there, and the Hellman's machine is now up to second because of that. Yakko has to drop back to third, but they still have to deal with that lap car of John Bunnell. Eric DeMax has caught John Bunnell again, and Bunnell is not going to give any room on the track there. He's going to try and defend his position there in terms of staying on the lead lap, but it's to no avail there. Eric DeMax able to get around him quite easily there after some contact though, but John Arndt's going to try and look on his outside there, and he's going to be able to try and outmaneuver that 53 there simply because of the amount of handling he has, but Bunnell's going to fight back. And certainly not what John Arndt really wants to see, is that 53 right next to him there, still fighting with him. So, and Alex Benyako and Richardson are still in that picture there. You see the Reese's and Zest car, as well as Sean Angel, as I mentioned earlier. As Arndt does get around that 53 there at last, and he's going to be chasing down Eric DeMax. Richardson goes to the inside to try and take advantage of the lap car as a pick, and that is a veteran move there from James Richardson. That is textbook racing there, and Sean Angel looks like he might want to do the same thing, but he can't really do it compared to Benyako, and Yakko's actually going to go to the left side of that 53 there. Looks like they're going to still try and navigate their way around John Bunnell, and Bunnell's still not really giving up whatsoever, but Sean Angel trying to really use this as an opportunity there as the leaders are coming down pit lane here. Green flag pit stops are set here for Canadian Tire. It looks like it will be a one-stop race, so it looks like everybody will be able to make it to the end. Aiden Shepherd and James Shelley would tangle up into the S's. Both would go into the sand trap and would slam into the concrete barrier. And pretty much they were also, I believe, they were both trying to get into pit lane. As Shepherd trying to get himself into pit lane, he shoves Juckum, and Juckum did not like that and turned the 60 into the wall, and he puts himself into the wall in the process there. But Aiden Shepherd has really had a season he kind of wants to forget. Outside the top 10 in points, and certainly he's had some wrecks that are not really of his doing either, so Shepherd is going to be not really going to be a happy camper after this one. And with James Shelley also getting that wreck, those two are really having some solid midfield runs there at most. So, pretty much a tough break for those guys, and they're going to probably plummet in the points because of it. Here's James Richardson coming out of his pits there. There you saw Eric DeMax and Arndt peering in the picture. There they are, and a fantastic stop from James Richardson there. Well done, Turner Performance. They have done an amazing job with their pit crew here, and they didn't make any mistakes like they did at Road America. So James Richardson, he's wanting to win yet again, as I mentioned probably earlier in this session. But James Richardson looking to try and find victory yet again. But Eric DeMax is right there. It's going to be a three-car battle for this win here potentially, as Richmond's still trying to hold on with DeMax on his bumper. Erica Max has been hungry for victory as well. And looks like they're all gonna go wide actually, and Arndt made some contact with that 5 car right into the corner panel. But those 3 cars are still going at it, and there you see a battle for the 4th spot between Sean Angel and Ben Yakko here. So if those two can actually catch up to the top 3, this could actually be a 5 car race to the end. Eric DeMax putting a lot of pressure on James Richardson, but John Arndt's gonna really shove him off the track there, intimidate him just a bit there, and Arndt's gonna go up to P2, and look who's coming into the picture. Sean Angel, a fellow Canadian, is gonna try and get himself up to that 3rd spot here. The Canadian crowd is going wild here at Canadian Tire there. They certainly want to see this 6th car in victory lane. It would be amazing to see that, and contact was made just a bit there, and that sends Eric DeMax a bit wide off the track there, and Alex Benyako, he's going to be on a mission to really catch those pack of cars there if he wants to put himself into contention for that race win. For those wondering about the top 2 in the point standings, TJ Martin actually leapfrogged Jake West out of pit lane with good strategy calls and a good pit stop. West couldn't really attack that 71 car in the pits, so looks like the strategy might have backfired for the Ford team there. Probably they just had a bad stop there, so again, these two are still running within the mid-pack area, but this is a good opportunity for the points contenders right behind them in the point stands to really gain some lost ground in terms of fighting for that championship. Anthony Marchese has been fading a bit in this run here. The adjustments haven't really helped the 66 car, and Jack Borkins is there to attack for the 11th position there. He put his nose underneath there. Marchese gave him plenty of room there, had to back off just a bit there, and the both of them are going to be side by side into the S's, and to that straightaway they go. Marchese still giving plenty of room there. They made a bit of door-to-door contact there, and they're side by side into the first corner. A really good high-speed corner right there, and Borkins is able to easily outmaneuver that 66 car. Jack Borkins now is going to have to chase down Will Lewis here. Will Lewis has been on a good charge here in this race for the Dodge team, or Fear Sport to be exact. And he's looking to try and gain some lost ground as well. He's not in the championship hunt as well as others, to say the least, but even so, a top 10 run is pretty much a good sign for the Fear Sport organization. Here comes Sean Angel on John Arndt's bumper. He shoves him up the track there. He gave him a bit of a bump and run in the S's there. And Sean Angel's gonna go up to P2 there. And now he's only got one more car to overtake. And that car is James Richardson in the 17 there. Sean Angel has gotta chase him down. With only a few laps remaining, he is running out of time. It'll be 4 laps to go here for James Richardson. He's gotta hold off Canadian Sean Angel, with John Arndt, the Richmond winner, running in 3rd. And with the road course winner of Alex Benyako running in 4th there, the winner of Road America. Benyako really trying to find a way to catch those 3 cars here, but Richardson has to deal with the lap car of Patrick Smith here. And they're giving blue flags to that 65 car, but he's not really yielding to James Richardson there, as Sean Angel's gonna see this as an opportunity to try and catch that number 17 car. Downed into Moss. That 17 car really couldn't get anything around that 65. He drives it really wide into the corner there into the Andretti straightaway. This is a perfect opportunity for Sean Angel to attack, and he's gonna do so here as they're side by side for the race lead. Rodriguez Racing versus Turner Performance there, both on Ford Power. And Sean Angel's gonna be able to take it away as the crowd's gonna go ecstatic here at Mossport. Sean Angel to the race lead there. Richardson has to find a way to get around this 6 car now. It's hard to pass the leader here in this track, but with the lap car in the way, this could be a somewhat of an advantage for James Richardson, or even a disadvantage, for him to be exact. Angel not able to get around Patrick Smith into the first corner there. Richardson right on the corner panel of that 6 car, trying to loosen him up. Into Clayton they go. Angel taking it nice and easy, still trying to methodically try and get his way around that 65 car. John Arndt and Alex Benyako are watching in the shadows there to see if they can do something about it. They just went through Quebec just now there, but Angels coming towards that long downhill. Very fast area to really do some good overtaking, and into Moss they go again. Sean Angel still on the bumper of Patrick Smith. He's gonna drive it wide there. Here comes James Richardson to the inside. He's gonna try and reclaim that lead. Again, they are side by side on the Andretti straight. This time the lines are inverse this lap. Richardson on the inside, Angel on the outside. Arndt trying to find a way to get himself into the picture as well. He's gonna try and maybe follow that 17. Angel fights back, he drives it wide. And here comes John Arndt to the inside. He does a sideswipe maneuver there. And he's gonna go to second here as they go to White's corner there. Arndt still trying to get around that six car, but James Richardson is loving that action right behind him. As he's now finally getting around Patrick Smith there, gave him a bit of a finger there. And Patrick Smith is gonna respond back by trying to race him a bit harder there. Arndt able to successfully take second away. But Angel's fighting back there in Clayton. And both of them are still going at it. Sean Angel still not giving up on a fight. Arndt drives it into the dirt there. Two wheels in the grass. They're still side by side, but look at the race etiquette those guys are showing right now. That is clean racing at its finest. Angel able to get the second spot back. But Richardson still trying to get around Patrick Smith here. But he's going to have the advantage here. Arndt looking on the inside. Angel on the outside there. He has to really stay there. He can't really do much. And John Arndt's gonna go up to second just like that. CM Racing has now put their car up to second here. John Arndt looking on a hot streak here in terms of the championship hunt. He won at Richmond in the Jackson's machine. Could he find victory here in the Helmans machine? And you just notice a blue car coming into the picture. That is Hannah Allen in the zero car. She's trying to put herself into that mix as well, trying to get herself into the top five potentially here. As here they come, coming with a white flag here. It is going to be one lap to go here at Mossport. James Richardson leads over John Arndt. Sean Angel still trying to get around Patrick Smith here, but Hannah Allen has made her way inside the top five. Arndt is running out of time here. Richardson has plenty of momentum here. He's got no obstructions in front of him, so he doesn't really have to worry about making a mistake here. But John Arndt's really going to try and drive it in deep if he needs to, if he wants to get to that 17th bumper. Eric DeMaxisi, he's getting held up by lap traffic there, but James Richardson still pulling away from John Arndt. Arndt's hard on the brakes there. He's going to try and see if he can do anything about it. Hard on the deep in the corner, and he drives it wide. That might be the race deciding factor right there. That's the variable that Richardson really needed in that 17 car. And through the Andretti straightaway for the final time, the Zest Machine has done a fantastic job all race. A great pit stop for James Richardson here has put him in the race lead, and that could have been the race winning move of the race there. That could have been the winning thing that could have helped him with this victory here. As he rounds the S's and into the final corner, James Richardson finds redemption here, and he's gonna win here at Mossport. And that is a spectacular job done and well-deserved win for James Richardson here. Certainly a driver to look out for. He was a monster at Road America. Hit the wall after pit stops, and that pretty much cost him that whole race there. But with a good pit stop and no mistakes really in the 17 car, and retaking the lead back in terms of a pressured situation there, car number 17 is in victory lane yet again. And this is really going to help them in the championship hunt. John Arndt gets a second place position here. Almost another win for that 88 team. They did win at Richmond though, but ever since then, I think they're as hungry as they always will be for the CM organization. Sean Angel gets a third place run. That's good for the Canadian crowd here. And Alex Bignacco gets a fourth place run. Hannah Allen fifth. Looks like Bignacco actually was able to overtake those two cars at the end there, with Eric DeMax dropping down to sixth. Alexander Rowe with a fantastic seventh place effort here today. Now that's good driving from that 05 team, certainly a run they wanted to see. Nick Salmon quiet run in the 8th spot, Williams 9th, and then last but not least, Alex Bignacco, rounding out your top 10 here. If you're wondering about those two contenders near the end, Jake West and Luke Martin, or not Luke Martin, but TJ Martin, finished 16th and 15th respectively there, so those two are pretty much going to stay consistent in terms of the points gap. I believe actually Martin may pull away by like 1 point, basically, but even so, the points gap between the top two is going to be pretty much as close as ever, but for the top three on down, they're going to be able to really catch up to them in this championship hunt. What a phenomenal race, though, near the end of the stint there. We had some good action near the end, not many incidences, actually, so that was good to see. So it was a lot more tame than last year's race, but congratulations to James Richardson on his victory here yet again. He is the winningest driver here in the Hardee's National Series.
There's a moment in your bones when the fire takes over. Blood is running, heart is pumping as the battle gets closer. They can say what they want now.